So, the new Mac Mini M2 Pro is out, and it comes with a superior M2 Pro chipset. You can also choose up to 32 gigabytes of RAM, and you can also pick an ultra-fast SSD inside.
No, you can't.
What? You can't? Okay, no, you can't actually pick a super-fast SSD inside the Mac Mini. But does that really matter? Well, today, I'm going to find out if it does really matter that we should have a faster SSD inside the Mac Mini and also in the likes of, say, the MacBook Air with the M2 chipset and also that MacBook Pro with the M2. And also, while we're at it, let's talk about the Mac Mini with the M2 as well. So rewind back to last year, we got a brand new M2 chipset, and in that we got tweaked up performance cores and also efficiency cores, and we also got an extra couple of cores in the actual GPU performance too inside the M2. However, one thing that did let us down was when we actually started testing out these MacBook Airs and also the MacBook Pro M2, we began to notice actually the storage speed was far, far slower. And we thought Apple were cutting corners. And let's be honest, they are cutting corners. But we'll get onto that a little bit later on. But in the grand scheme of things, did it really make a difference in sort of doing video exporting and sort of general tasks with your sort of MacBook Pro or your M2 MacBook Air? Well, we'll come to the answer in just a minute, because we do also have now the brand new Mac Mini, and inside this too, we've actually noticed for the M2 chipset compared to the M1 chipset inside this machine, actually the actual storage is also slower in this too. And not only this, we've also noticed if you put an M2 Pro chipset inside this, that the storage inside this machine is still not as fast in the likes of what you could get in a 14 or 16 inch MacBook Pro. And talking about the 14 inch and 16 inch MacBook Pros, actually the storage is a tiny bit slower in them too. But going back, why is the storage slower this time round? Well, there are multiple reasons for this. The first one could be that Apple are trying to cut corners. So right now we do have a recession coming and it's impacting us. Obviously, Apple have had to increase the prices of some of their Macs. So noticeably, the 16-inch MacBook Pro is a bit more dearer than what we got last generation with the 16-inch MacBook Pros with either the M1 Pro or the M1 Max. The 14-inch has stayed about the same. But funny enough, that actually in the Mac Mini that we've got here with the normal M2 chipset, actually the cost of it is $100 less compared to the M1 chipset that we got about 2 years ago. So really kind of the price is reflected in the Mac Mini, that obviously we do have a slower sort of storage inside it. So that kind of makes sense. But what about the MacBook Pro? What is going on there? Because at the end of the day, the storage in that is actually a tiny bit slower to the last generation. And I believe the main reason is because, like I said, the cost of living is going up. We're hitting a recession, so things are getting more and more expensive. It's just the natural way of things. So this could be partly the reason why Apple are basically cut-casting their sort of way around things. They're basically changing the way how they build their SSDs up, basically, so to make them a little bit slower. But there again, does it really matter that they are a bit slower when you're actually doing sort of saying video exports and things like this? Well, have a look here at a video export of what I've done here on a 14 and 16 inch MacBook Pro with an M2 Pro and also with a Mac Mini with an M2 Pro chipset inside it. And this is the exact same export. As you can see here, the export is basically neck and neck. All three of the machines, like I say, have the exact same 12 cores CPU, and they also have the 19 core GPU inside it, and they all exported the same 4K H.264 file. And what this had on it, this had up to about 3 4K streams on it all at once, and also had separate audio too, and it managed to export everything together all around the same sort of speed. So as we can see here, straight away, having a slower SSD in this Mac Mini doesn't really do any difference. So really, I think Apple actually personally, in my opinion, made a mistake when they brought out the M1 Mac Mini, because they over sort of thought of how much sort of storage sort of speeds were actually needed. So there's not even really a bottleneck today as there wasn't back then, because generally the kind of tasks that you'll be doing on this machine, the storage is more than fast enough for your needs. Obviously, it's great to do copy and pasting from, say, an external sort of hard drive or external SSD, what can go up to, say, I don't know, sort of Thunderbolt 3 or 4 speeds, kind of sort of 40 gigabytes, those kind of speeds, and transferring it onto the internal sort of storage that we have inside it. Obviously, that is going to be far, far quicker, but generally speaking, it doesn't really matter too much. When you're doing actually sort of the actual tasks of exporting and also moving things around, so you would actually be creating videos and bits like this and creating photos, really the actual storage speed doesn't really matter at all, because we've actually hit the limitation of the M2 Pro chipset and it can't actually export or do anything any more faster. So the storage speed is more than enough. And I believe this is the same case for, say, the MacBook Air. Obviously, the MacBook Air, you wouldn't be buying this MacBook Air to be doing all your 4K video edits on it. You would not be loading, say, wedding videos onto this machine and editing it all the time as your main machine. You might have it as an on-the-go sort of device or a backup device if you can afford it. But at the end of the day, this wouldn't be your primary machine for those reasons. And Apple know this. The MacBook Air is designed for the kind of general kind of user out there. And they know that if you do want that kind of pro performance, then you'd go and pick yourself the 14 or 16 inch MacBook Pro, but does actually have a faster SSD inside it, because that is what that machine is designed for. And it's the same with the Mac Studio too. You would only pick both of these machines or one of these machines if you know you're going to be needing super fast speeds, because you're doing lots of sort of video editing, you're doing 8K streams and things like this, or lots of sort of photo sort of buffering and bits and pieces like that on these machines. You wouldn't be buying either of these computers just to be doing Word on it, or just browsing the internet, or maybe putting a filter on a photo that you took on your iPhone. You wouldn't be buying it for these reasons at all. There'd be no point with this. And personally, combined with Apple trying to make things a little bit cheaper so they can keep the cost around the same or only rise it a little bit, I think this is the reason why storage is a little bit slower. I think Apple overestimated on how fast they needed the SSDs to be inside their M1 series of Macs, and now they've decided to actually cut it back a little bit in the M2 series. And for that, we do feel a little bit sort of shortchanged or a little bit cheapened by that. But like I said, what Apple should have done is in the first generation of the M1 series of Macs, they should have had that same sort of storage setup what we're now getting in the M2 series. If we had got that experience on day one, I don't think we wouldn't be having as much of the sort of niggles or the complaints that we have now. Because at the end of the day, like I say, it has been cut back. And then again, we do really feel cheapened out by that. And that is my thoughts on why I think that basically Apple have actually decided to cut back on the storage kind of speeds. I would love to know what your thoughts are as well on this, so do put them down in the comments below. And on that note, guys, it's also time to wrap up this video. So if you have enjoyed watching it, please do press the like button. And also at the same time as well, if you want to hear the latest Apple news, reviews, and comparisons, please also make sure you subscribe to the channel and also hit that notification bell. Until next time, guys, I will see you really soon. Take care. Bye-bye.